This is the 2020 Experience Podcast, and this is episode number 7. And we kind of had a fun time of the year in that it's people are starting to look at summer. The weather's starting to clear a little bit, and people are starting to think about pool season.
Pool season.
Okay. And it's a topic on a lot of people's minds all year round, but now we're through the holidays, and people want to get leaner.
Yeah. To take off the shirt or not take off the shirt.
Yeah, whether
you... That is the question.
Yeah, exactly. And so what we wanted to do today is talk to somebody. We have a guest today who has experience in getting lean or getting ripped, however you want to call it. But basically, I wanted to talk today about what to do, how to do it, what you've done. Mm-hmm. And this is Jeremy, what he's done. And then... you know, what are some reasons that people do not get lean? And I also want to talk about, you know, in this conversation, I think we're going to go how you found 2020.
Yeah.
And, you know, kind of what does getting ripped then, back when you started,
mm-hmm.
How does it differ to now, and what will you do going forward to either maintain or to help others?
Yeah.
So start off with, like, where, you know, like, go back to what you were saying before we started. Go back to when you were 180 pounds. So,
yeah.
So Jeremy, you're 6'2", 220.
20, yep. 6'2", okay. 220.
So a large human being.
Yeah, but probably between the 10 and 12% of the body fat, probably 13%, according to whatever measurements. But didn't start that way at all, not even close. And there's been so many different fluctuations that it's kind
of... You were a
crazy.
Skinny little guy in high school.
Very skinny. Same height, so 40 pounds lighter.
Yeah.
Maybe even like the 175, 180, 80 range.
Right.
And I actually used to run with I did golf in high school, mm-hmm. and I would run with the cross country team for their practices because the golfers didn't do anything on the side. So I would go run with the cross country team.
You didn't have swing fit back then?
We didn't have swing fit back then.
Oh, man.
Yeah, no, didn't have swing fit. And I was always fascinated. I've always been fascinated with bodybuilding. Like in yeah. the
magazines
and like wanting to get ripped and want like just getting freaking ginormous,
right?
And so I bought Arnold's Encyclopedia of Bodybuilding.
This is when you're in the Navy or
no? That's high school.
This is high school.
It's like sophomore or sophomore junior year. No, I was junior year because I had my license. I take it back. I was a senior when I got my license. So
got you. Some people wait. You might
no,
not
I was 16. The summer of before my.
Junior year,
that's right. Yeah. It's a long time ago.
Yeah.
Not really, it's 10 years. But anyways, and I got the Arnold's Encyclopedia of Bodybuilding, and my buddy
which
and I... Which we recommend.
Still good to look at.
Oh, absolutely. I still have it. And I would, my buddy and I would go to the YMCA, local YMCA, and we'd try and figure out what the heck we were doing, right? Mm-hmm. Do whatever it said in there, bicep curls, all that fun stuff.
Yeah.
Had no clue what was going on. Still stayed skinny because I didn't do it consistently. Like,
yeah.
I'd go run... with a cross-country team because I thought that was the workout.
Sure.
And then we'd just play around in the gym, right? So that was, you know, junior, senior. Kind of did a lot more running then, a lot more cardio, swimming, stuff like that. Getting prepped for the Navy because I overall wanted to go and do Navy SEAL stuff. Mm-hmm. And you have to have some crazy endurance for it, or so they say. And so I, you know, started working out for that. Went in the Navy... and didn't work out the first couple of years in the Navy, just kind of maintained whatever they told us to. They didn't tell us to do many
things. What was your body composition at this time?
Still same, 180.
Okay, well, got you. So no changes.
No changes,
nothing happened.
Yeah. On the weekends, I'd actually have...
you were relatively fit, though.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Right.
I was skinny fit.
You were skinny fit, yeah.
Skinny fit, yeah. I could run a lot. I could do push-ups, sit-ups, and pull-ups, all that fun stuff. Mm-hmm. But I was 100.
Were you very lean at this point?
No.
Okay.
Remember when you said you're vegan and it was kind of like
skinny fat.
You're skinny fat.
Yeah.
I was skinny fat.
Yeah.
On the weekends, I'd have the Chewy Chips Ahoy chocolate chip cookies, an entire box of those with the Bold Party Mix Chex Mix.
Did you microwave them?
No. You just eat them out the box.
You microwave them. And
are you serious?
For like 10 or 15 seconds.
And you just...
Before
I've never had time to microwave them. I just eat the whole box.
Yeah, exactly. Put it in my mouth.
And they have
and
the peely thing, so you can peel off the top, and then you can eat just straight out.
Okay,
of it.
But so anyways, that was your weekend.
It was Saturday and Sunday.
Sure.
And I'd sit there, I'd eat, you know.
Right.
Well, I finally got a roommate in the barracks who was like swole. Like he came in and he's like doing curls in his room type swole.
Right.
And I was like, that's pretty sweet. And he asked me,
what are
like,
you doing?
Yeah. I didn't even have to ask. He's like, hey, bro, do you want to come work out with me one time? I was like, yes. Yes, I do. And so I went and we just started like lifting heavy stuff.
Like what?
Lots of volume. I mean, we were doing deadlifts, back squats.
You're doing legs.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Deadlifts, back squats. We were doing weighted pull-ups. We were doing, I mean, five sets of five weighted pull-ups. And
sure.
We're most of the time, what helped tremendously, he was bigger than me and stronger. So I'm trying to do his weights
sure.
all the time. He's doing sets of five and 10. I'm doing sets of three and five.
Good.
Which overall, I think, helped me.
Sure.
And helped me grow a lot faster.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I started seeing some results. I started getting some muscle, putting on some size.
Yeah.
I'm over 200 pounds now.
Yeah.
And I'm like, okay, this is awesome.
So it's starting to work.
Starting to work, yeah. So then I got a new roommate who didn't work out, but then I still, since I was consistent with him, I was like, all right, let's keep on going.
Keep the program going, yeah.
Keep on going. And kept on lifting heavy weights. It was a chest and tries, back and buys,
yeah.
legs and shoulders type split, but it worked because yeah. I was consistent. Like I went every day. It didn't matter if I, like in the Navy, you'd work a 12-hour shift or 14 hours or 16 hours, no matter what, I still went to the gym afterwards.
Sure.
Like
even how many days a week?
I mean, every day but Sunday. Every day but Sunday. And I mean, you just went. Even if you did something like, even if I did like, some push-ups and sit-ups. Like, even if it was just something small, no right. matter what, I made myself go.
Do something.
Do something, because I didn't want to lose the gains that I had
right.
that I had gotten. So weights continually increase. Well, then...
How's your body composition?
It's point? Getting better, right? So I'm getting more muscular. I was probably 210. I would say between 205 and 210.
Were you getting leaner?
I was getting leaner.
Getting
leaner. I was getting a lot leaner. Yeah, yeah. So like abs were starting to show.
Yeah, and you were doing, how much cardio were you doing?
Oh, like no cardio.
Like, so you weren't running or rowing?
Rowing,
or
no. I didn't even know what a rower was.
Long duration?
I didn't do, there was no CrossFit yet.
Yeah.
I didn't do yep. CrossFit yet. So it was literally chest and tries, right. back and buys,
right.
legs and shoulders, right?
Yeah. Heavy.
Heavy,
yeah.
heavy. Rest, 2 minutes of rest in between sets. Sometimes if you're supersetting, then you're doing a set of deadlifts followed by a set of bench press, and then
right.
you're gonna rest
right.
until you feel really recovered, and
yeah.
then you do it again. But each set that you did was like, okay, I'm going as hard as I possibly can.
Right.
Like, you might not make five reps.
You make four.
But you make four, right?
Right?
And then you keep on going. So then the next person that I run into is... Oh man, Reggie Wilson.
Reggie, big, if you're listening, thank you.
Big black dude. He could deadlift like 500 pounds for 10 times, right? So no joke. Just
wow.
Like his arms were the size of my legs. I was like, bro, can I please work out with you? Like I went up to him.
What are you doing?
Yeah. I didn't know who he was. I just went up to him. I was like, can I please work out with you? He's like, yeah, if you can keep up. He's like, okay, fine.
I'll keep up.
Yeah. So the first workout I did with him was a deadlift. He's like, we're going to deadlift today. Like, we're going to start off with deadlifts. No warm-up. We just start with empty bar, do some reps. He did 10 reps of bar. Throw a wheels on, 45s. 10 reps. Okay, throw two more on. Okay, 10 reps. Okay, two more on. Okay, now it's like 8 reps. By this time, I'm like struggle buzz city. 315,
yeah.
and I'm like, okay, wow, right?
So got it's real.
Like, yeah, got real. All right, throw two more on. So we're at 405 now, right? And even bust out like 8 reps. I'm like, oh, I've never done this, right?
Right.
So I pick it up once. I'm like, heck yeah. Throws two more on, 500, right? Well, 495.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro, I just did one right here. He's like, you ain't gonna know if you don't ever try. I was like, oh, dang. All right, so
see,
I go to pick it up and I go, nothing. Didn't even move off the ground.
Right.
Next week, Monday, deadlifting. Same exact thing, right?
Yeah.
I start to move the bar just a little bit.
Sure.
Nothing, right? Monday, same exact thing. Okay.
Third week. Yeah.
I picked the bar up to my shins and I was like ecstatic. He's like,
right.
bro, you're almost there. And he's doing like 10 reps, right? And so, fourth week, right? I get it up to my knees. Now I'm
okay.
seeing progress. Like, so
right.
now, like,
right.
every Monday, I'm
yeah.
thinking
like,
about
looking forward to it.
I'm
like,
doing this 495.
Am I going to get it close?
Yeah, yeah. Sixth week, I go in and I'm like, Reggie, today's the day, man. He's like, yeah, it is. Right. And he's like, he's crushing it. Right. And so go up, get all pumped up. Right. Had a belt on, no straps or nothing. And I got it.
That's 6 weeks.
But every Monday, we did that deadlift thing. Same thing. 145, 225, 315, 405.
Jeez. Yeah,
but what was cool was the 405, right? Next thing you know, like the third week, I'm doing 3 to 5 reps.
Sure, right. So you stepped it up.
And you don't even think about it because I was thinking about the 495.
Because you set a high enough goal.
Because you said, yeah, something I couldn't even do. Now, I still had you know, good form with it, right? Sure. I could feel my stomach, you know, I'm feeling my butt and my hammies. I never had any back pain or anything. But it was just that, like, that progressively trying to move that immovable object that, like, got me. And that's where I saw my biggest gains. So, like, without knowing it, over those 6 weeks, I was taking, you know, a protein shake with creatine, right? And, you know, drinking tons of water. I was eating a lot of food. I wasn't doing a ton of cardio. But, like, my weight shoot up to, like, 215.
Right.
So, and I was, like, lean. Like, I was getting more muscular.
Right.
Like, the more, even though I was getting bigger, I looked bigger than I was because I was leaner.
Because you're leaner,
yeah,
right,
I was a lot leaner. So the leaner you are, you don't have to be huge to be, you don't have to be 250 pounds to look big.
No, and we'll talk about how this is not, you know, because a lot of people want to get lean and they don't want to get big.
Yeah.
So that'll be an important, we'll have that conversation at the end, but I want to keep going on the journey. So then what?
So at that point, I'm like, all right, dang, I'm pretty strong. I'm pretty fit. Right, because you still got to run a mile and a half for the Navy, so I could still do, you know, a mile and a half in like 9.5 minutes. So it's like, all right, didn't do too much running, still just doing weights, and I could still run halfway decent.
Right, 6 minute miles.
Yeah, and so my buddy Derek Weicker, who he actually does this thing called 4-Caliber Fitness now, and so he's teaching people in CrossFit gyms how to use guns and be safe, like be aware of like your situations. Like, so they have fake guns that they use, and like they bring a car in and they do like scenarios. Like, and he teaches people how. He was a rescue swimmer who actually went to Buds to be a SEAL. He did ring the bell, but he's a freak.
Yeah.
And he was doing CrossFit in his garage, and he's like, he was a good friend of mine. He's like, dude, you're pretty strong. You should come try and do this CrossFit thing.
Right.
I was like,
sounds like a lot of stories.
Sure, why not? Let's do it. And the first workout was Elizabeth. So 135 pound cleans and ring dips. And I was like, 135? I'm deadlifting like 500 pounds. Let's do this, right? Never done a squat clean before in my life. Didn't even know like what a squat clean was, right?
What they're about to do.
Yeah. And the ring dips, there was no rings in the Globo gym. So I'd done regular dips.
Sure, like, all day long.
Done. Easy. I think it took me 20 minutes.
Right.
Like,
so that workout is like a 10-minute workout.
Yes.
And it should be fast.
It literally destroyed me. Like, but I laid on the ground and I was like, okay, now it's changed.
Now we figured something out.
Now we figured something out. Like, okay, working out and getting swole is pretty huge. Just lifting weights.
Getting strong is
getting
important.
Getting strong was important and cool. But this CrossFit thing, okay, that's pretty neat.
Right.
Right. So then I started working out with him in his garage, and he would, once again, I always found someone who would destroy me at everything.
Somebody beat you up, right.
Oh my gosh. So I'm going 10 times harder.
Where was this?
This was in Jacksonville, Florida, down in the Navy. And he had rings and everything. And so he was in my squadron, and we went on deployment together. So he brought his rings and we work out together. And so set up the rings and we're like, all right, so the workout we're doing today is 30 muscle ups for time. I'm like, dude, I've never done a muscle up. I don't even know. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
And so he does it. He does it in like under 5 minutes. Like, he's a freak. Yeah, like a freak.
Jeez.
And I can't do one. So he's like, all right, so here's what you're going to do. 3 ring pull-ups and 3 ring dips, 30 times.
Right.
I was like, oh my.
So 90.
90.
Oh, gotcha.
So 90
so you
reps
credit of 3 to 1.
Okay. 3 to 1. I've never been so sore in my life. Right. But it was fantastic. Like, I felt amazing.
You worked hard.
I worked really, really hard. But it was always that person right next to me that's like just crushing me at everything.
Right.
And then I can't do what he's doing, so I have to do something harder than what I probably should be doing just to try and do it. Like,
just trying to get caught up.
Just trying to get caught up. And so my weight stayed the same. So 215. I stayed solid 215, but I got lean.
Yep.
Right. So now I'm lifting the heavy weights, but then I'm also doing like sprint work with it. So we do some deadlifts beforehand, get heavy, And then he'd make me do something that I couldn't even come close to keeping up with him on. And we'd just do stuff like that. We'd mix in body stuff.
You're adding layers to your fitness. You started with the basis of strength, which is why, you know, like last night people were looking at you did, you had more weight on your bar for a power clean last night than I can deadlift, almost. And people are like, well, how do you get that strong? I'm like, well, you have to do the strength work first. Yeah, and I think that's, so basically taking us through your narrative, you built this baseline of strength.
Yeah.
Through just like straight up kind of old school bodybuilding.
Yeah.
But then you kind of realized there's more to that. And then you found the next layer.
Yeah.
Which was CrossFit.
CrossFit, yeah.
So then what happened?
So
we haven't talked about food much yet.
No. No.
Because you're still young.
Yes. Yeah, no, I was 21, 22. Right. And I'm eating everything I can. Right.
Just
eating everything
you run
I
hot.
Can. I was lean. I wasn't like I wasn't as like crazy cut. I was lean. I looked pretty good. Like I looked above average than other people. And you know, I kept on doing that. I kept on doing what I did. Didn't change anything about the diet. Just kept on eating whatever I could, as much as I could.
And would you say most people do that?
Yeah.
For a while.
Oh yeah.
Until what happens?
So and then I got out of the Navy, and I was like, oh dang, I want to start getting lean. Debbie makes fun of me all the time. She's like. She would come. So I used to work at this
gym. Debbie is Jeremy's wife.
My wife, yeah. I used to work at this gym called Peak Fitness. It was just a global gym, but I do CrossFit workouts there. They had a little CrossFit section. And she'd come in, and I would have a bowl of plain spinach leaves and canned chicken. Right? Yeah. So I would undo the canned chicken. I'd put it in the spinach leaves, no dressing or nothing. Right? And just eat it.
Okay,
just,
that's one way to do
just
it.
Just straight up eat it. Yeah, like, and I'd be super strict for about 3 months.
Yeah.
Like, I'm eating spinach and canned chicken. I have protein shakes. Like, I had this protein shake mixture that I would have every single day.
Right.
Like, which is like protein powder, almond milk. What was else in there? There was some oats.
Peanut butter,
creatine. There's peanut butter or almond butter. I love the peanut butter, so I would have it. I like the almond butter better now.
Yeah.
And bunch of protein powder, some milk if I was feeling froggy. Either that or that was just water. Yeah. And then I'd have that in the morning and after workouts.
Right.
And I'd be crushing spinach leaves and tuna fish, cans of tuna.
Yeah.
I can't tell you how many cans of tuna fish I'd have.
But you would eat the same thing.
Oh, all the time.
Every day.
Every day.
So, and I will say, guys do a better job with that than ladies, because like, I know at home, like, I can eat the same thing day after day, and Britt's like, no, we need to
have some variance.
Change it up a little bit. Yeah. So.
Constantly varied food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so now we're starting to think more about food.
Yes, starting to think a lot more about food. But I didn't know as much detail. I just knew I had to eat some meat and some veggies,
right?
And just couldn't eat crap. I got rid of the cookies.
Sure.
For 3 months, like legit, no cookies, no candy. I didn't know anything about sugar back then. I just knew that it was not good for you.
Right.
And when I ate it, I felt horrible. Right. That's all I knew. That was about the extent of it. And what they say on TNation.com.
Right. Yes.
And so I just tried to eat a bunch of that lean stuff.
Yeah.
And so that is after Navy, I'm working at the Peak Fitness. I'm getting ready to move to Australia. That's when I meet Debbie, right? And then I meet her October. I leave for Australia in January. Right. She stays here. I did CrossFit there, couldn't afford to pay for the gym there.
Right.
And so my buddy had some kettlebells, and so we would just do kettlebells and just a bunch of bodyweight stuff.
Right.
Right. Stayed lean. I got weaker. I did not get stronger. I didn't get bigger or anything. Yeah. I just kind of maintained.
Right.
And then came back in, January, February, March, April, May. Came back in May. Mm-hmm. Debbie and I got married in July.
Right. No waiting.
Met in October, married in July, and I was gone for 5 of those months. So that's fantastic.
It's a good way to start a relationship, though.
Long distance.
Seriously.
Yeah. Talk about communication skills. So got married, moved to Kansas City, went to Midwestern Baptist Theological Seminary, and I didn't really work out. I kind of stopped working out right then. Married. Running out of time, doing some school stuff. I had
a baby comes in.
Not until the next year.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah, not until the next year. And that's, he's the reason I got my level one. Mm-hmm. I've always loved fitness.
Yeah.
I've like loved fitness, and I've even when I was at like Globo gyms and stuff working out, like I loved being able to like people come up and ask me questions, and I love being able to help them. Or since I always had that person that was one step above me, that would like I'd go up and ask, "What
now
are you
your
doing?"
Turn.
Now it's like my turn, and I felt like people would come up, and I'd be like, "Yeah, hey, you want to work out with me?
Yeah, sure.
Let's work out, and I'll show you everything that I've done to try and get you where I am," because it's like so hugely helpful.
Right.
And so I always wanted something like that, right? I always wanted to do that my entire life. And so I was going to school. I started to get back into working out again after probably, what, 3-4 months of, it's probably 6 months of being married. Mm-hmm. And during that time, I got a little fluffy.
Yeah.
I was...
Did you gain weight?
No, I dropped weight. Yeah, so I got back to skinny fat. So I was probably under 200 pounds at that time. So I was probably in the 190.
Back down by me.
Back down to 195,
yeah.
198. And then started working out again. And I was like, okay, let's go back to lifting some heavy stuff. Mm-hmm. And then, so my go-to was always go back to lift heavy stuff. Right, bodybuilding type
stuff. You saw it worked.
Yeah, bodybuilding type stuff with a Metcon at the end. So I'm still doing CrossFit, but I prioritize
lifting something heavy
first. So did that, and then little Weston Wayne comes around in October. So he was born in October, and I was like, there's a level one on Thanksgiving. I don't know what I can do with this. I want to have my own gym eventually. Let's, Debbie, I got to do this. So it's on Thanksgiving weekend. My dad, it's Weston's first Thanksgiving. My dad comes down for Weston's first Thanksgiving. So that Saturday, I was like, I gotta go, guys.
Right.
And so we took some savings out.
I was gonna say, that's $1,000.
Yeah,
for
1,000
a family
bucks.
And
To not know, and we're in this crappy apartment.
Right.
And I'm in seminary.
Right.
You know.
So it's not like revenue, money's pouring
no.
in.
And I was a bartender at the National Golf Course. And so I was like, all right, I'm gonna do this level one. And so I went, did the level one for the weekend. It was amazing. I'm like, all right, now what am I going to do with this?
Right.
I got to do something with it. So that was in end of November. December comes rolling around. And my brother-in-law, Bobby. Yeah, Bobby T. Pitts. He goes, I told him I'm doing this CrossFit stuff. And I was like, man, I want to start a gym. Like, I'm going to find a garage. I'm going to just do it. I bought some kettlebells.
Right.
I had the two yellows and a green.
And which
is good. It was fancy. Still have them. And he's like, well, dude, I just did a video for this guy who has this CrossFit gym in Prairie Village. I'm like, what the heck is Prairie Village? Where is this at? Because I'm up in the Northlands.
Right.
He's like, oh, really nice guy, John. You like him? Oh, can I see the video? And so it kind of showed me. I was like, that is awesome, right? I'm gonna email this guy. Can I have his email address just to get some advice from you? Like, literally was just like, hey, I want it. So I emailed you. And didn't hear anything back right off the bat.
I think there was a couple days.
It was, and so I actually had called Bobby, and I was like, "Dude, is it hard to get a hold of him?" Or like, he's pretty dang busy. Pretty dang busy.
Well, I was janitor, coach.
You were everything. Well, and plus, it's this random dude who's like, "Hey, I want to start a gym. Could you give me some advice?"
So I thought I'd let it fester for a little bit.
Yeah. So I was like, "All right, I think I emailed you again," and then you responded, you're like, "Yeah, why do you want to do CrossFit?" And I was like, okay, all right, let me.
It's a good question.
Yeah. So then I wrote it on my list. And you're like, yeah, come on in and we'll check you out. So I actually went to the front door and I'm sitting there. We had Bible study that night. I was sitting there like, dang, where in the heck is everybody? Like sitting by the front door. I'm like, all right, it's 15 minutes past the time you told me to be here. So I'm like, I got there 15 minutes early.
Right.
So I'm sitting there waiting. And then I'm 30. And I'm like, dang, where? So then finally I just like, all right, I'm going to walk around. So I walk around the other side. I come in. I'm like, all right.
Yeah. So for those of you, if you're watching this, like our front door is to the front street, 73rd Terrace, but it's locked. Like we just use it as a coach's entrance.
Yeah.
But the main entrance is around the side. So you have to like drive around into the back parking lot.
Yes. And so I come in, I'm wearing jeans and a polo shirt and I'm like, I'm kind of nervous because I'm just talking to you about how to start a gym.
Yeah.
And you're like, we started talking, chatting, and you're like, hey, you want to do the workout? I was like, yes, I do. the workout was Fat Cindy.
Yeah.
And
30-20-10?
Yeah,
10-20-30
for 20 minutes. And I was like, all right. I mentally thought, all right, this guy is further up than me, and I need to impress him with my working out.
Go hard.
Yeah. Go hard.
Yeah.
So I went hard.
Yeah.
Holy biceps and just arms from just... They hurt yeah. so bad for the next like week.
Yeah, all the connective tissue.
It was just hurting so bad, but I went hard, and I was like, "All right, how do I keep on coming back?" So I think I kept on emailing a few times, and I was like, "Hey, would you mind if I just came and watched?"
Right.
And you're like, "Yeah, sure. Go ahead, come watch."
Fine.
So I drive up from the Northland,
which is a half an hour.
Yeah. So classes are 5:30 in the morning, and so I'd drive my happy self up here after bartending the night before.
Right.
And I'd be like, all right, I'm just going to follow him around. And so I'd follow you around. Yeah. And just follow you around. And then you'd be like, do you want to stay and work out? Yeah.
Yes, I want to work.
Please? Yes. Yeah. And so then drive back, go to school, do the bartending thing. Weston is still there. So in the picture. So
one.
Yeah.
He just turned one.
No, he was still. No, because this
is. He hadn't turned one yet.
No, he was only. Because he was born in October, so we're in February right now.
Right.
So he's only like what, 4 months old.
Right.
Yeah, 4 months old, and so then
was this the 1 year old birthday party? Was that the Cubs party?
That was the Cubs party.
Yeah. So that was still 6 months away.
Yeah. And so, then so after like a couple weeks of that, you're like, hey, do you wanna like start shadowing type deal? Like shadow two classes and everything. I was like, yeah, absolutely. And so. And it was still just a we're just talking type deal.
Right.
And so I'd come at.
If you want to come and watch, you can come and watch. Anybody's welcome to come and watch.
Yeah. And so I'm doing it more frequently Monday, Wednesday, Friday, mm-hmm. and just driving up. Like driving in the morning, driving back, bartending at night, coming back in. And Debbie's like, okay, what are you doing? Are you doing
working
anything?
There? Or what, yeah.
Yeah.
What's going on?
It's like, I'm just learning. I'm going to try and do this. And for our Bible study people, Eric and Chelsea, they had a garage. And I was like, hey, guys, what do you do with that garage? Do you want to work out? Because at the time, I still was like, I want to do my own gym, right?
Right.
And so learning from you, and I'm like, all right, I'm learning some stuff now. Let's test it on some people.
Right.
I'm at level one.
Does it work?
Yeah, does it work? So they're like, yeah, you want to use your garage? So I made an order on Rogue, and I ordered like a barbell, some more kettlebells. We just started working out in the garage. And actually before that, they actually came to our apartment and I had them working out with kettlebells.
Perfect.
And so it was fantastic. It was a great
experience. Much.
No, just make it up as you go.
Right.
And so I would do that on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and then Monday, Wednesday, Friday, did I come drive here.
Right.
Right. And then moved into that garage, still doing it on Tuesdays and Thursdays and any other free time that I had to go over there and help them with that.
Yeah.
And then from there, where did we go from there? It was like still in that apartment. And then I think like it was probably like 3-4 months. And then you're like, hey, you sat me down and you're like, all right, what are we doing?
Right.
You had that, what are we doing?
Right.
And I was like, you're like, do you want to work here?
Right.
And so then I would shadow the 5:30, work out at the 6:30, and then I would do the 7:30 a.m. class.
Coach it. Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
And so I'd do that until 8:30 in the morning, drive back home, go to school, do the bartending thing. And then just
repeat,
rinse and repeat, keep on going and going. It's like, this is amazing. Everything I want to do right now.
Mm-hmm.
And so I would do that. And then I think you started asking me for more time. Like, hey, do you want
to... What about afternoon? What if you stayed till noon?
Yeah. Right? And you just kept adding on some layers, And I'm like, okay, this is it. So then I'm still going back and forth. And so that's like at Weston's birthday party.
Right.
Because in that December, I had started talking to some people up in Liberty about renting a space.
Right.
There's two guys from our church that had a space up in Liberty Square. Awesome space. I'm working the numbers out. Thought it was an awesome space. Yes. So yeah, that's...
Tell that story.
Yeah. And so I'm like, okay. John, so what do I do? What do I do? You're kind of helping me out here and there. And one thing I ran into before even wanting to take that space was, okay, by myself, I know I could do it.
Yeah.
I don't know how well I could do it. But if I go under you as a mentor and work with you and with this great, like, amazing community of people, like, my ceiling is then removed. Like, I could have gone by myself, and I think I would have done fine.
No doubt.
Like, ceiling's only so high. I didn't have a team. I didn't have that person that was one step above me.
Right, that's been a recurring theme.
A recurring theme.
You need to find that workout buddy though, still.
You do, absolutely. And so I didn't have that, and I was like, crap. I can try and do this, and I'm gonna limit myself, or I can just, like, suck up my ego and say, hey, I need someone above me.
Well, I think you remember that, like, we had conversations about, like, you want to compete individually.
Oh yeah.
You want to grow professionally. You want to get into a house, you know.
Yeah.
So like just from personal experience, like, you can't do all three. Like, something's gonna give, and it's usually gonna be the competing thing.
Yeah.
Like, that's gonna go away. Your ability to train is gonna go away. So
yeah.
Like, you thought long and hard about being able to try and do all three of those.
Absolutely.
Versus picking and choosing.
One of the hard part was Debbie wanted me to do it. Mm-hmm. She's like, right. You've been talking about going out on your own forever. Right. I want you to friggin' do it. Matt, like, why are you not doing this?
Yeah.
And I was like, you know,
which
just...
is different, because most of the time it's like...
the opposite way around.
Right.
Yeah. And she's always pushed me really hard, which is why I love her.
Yeah.
But I was like, this is just something, just, you know, I just need to go under someone. Like, I need to not be limited by myself.
Yeah.
I guess I could say. And so, which actually turned out perfect, because I think like 2 months later, after I told the guys no.
You would have been in.
Yeah, would have been in, throwing, slamming weights around. The building we actually wanted collapsed. Like, Adam.
I mean, nobody was hurt, right?
No one was hurt. Okay. It happened
so
at
we
night.
Can, we can laugh about it. But yeah. Still.
But like, Adam was like, dude, that building you were going to rent, it collapsed.
Yeah.
I was like, holy crap.
Yeah.
Like, I can't imagine...
all your
where
stuff in there, just
everything just gone. Or
rubble.
Even if people were there and were slamming weights around,
right?
Next thing you know, the building collapses. That's so. I mean, thank God for that,
right?
And then moved into a different garage. We're still in the apartment and coming here much more frequently, mm-hmm. like every morning.
It almost turned into a job. And when did you leave the National?
I didn't leave the National for.
Kept that around.
So actually, I didn't leave the National until like the year, like a year and three quarters being here,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
because at that time I was
to keep them both going.
To keep them both going, mm-hmm. and I was further along with the National to try and get money for a house than I was
sure.
here.
Right.
And
right.
so I needed that time there
right.
To establish,
to build your income,
build an income, and all that fun stuff. And so, that was a year and probably almost three quarters of the year going through that. Still doing both, still doing mornings, right. and then still I'd add in a noon, mm-hmm. And I actually cut school out because mm-hmm. I wanted to utilize this as an avenue to reach people.
Right.
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 And so, which CrossFit is fantastic for.
Right.
And so, stopped going to school, was doing both here and there, and then still had the garage on the side.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So there's three things juggling with a baby and a wife.
And a wife,
who
yeah.
is also going to school for cosmetology.
Right.
So there's quite a few things going on.
Busy. If you want something done, give it to a busy person.
Yeah. And so kept on doing that. But eventually I realized that no garage anymore. It's time to just full focus over here. Right.
Yeah.
So all my stuff moved into, we actually moved into a house right up the street.
Yeah.
Because we're like, okay, if we're going to commit to this 2020.
Save you a whole bunch of time driving.
Yeah, no kidding. Because it's still driving an hour every single day.
Right.
30 minutes here and back. Plus, it'll be nicer to wake up in the morning, not at.
Yeah, save a half hour of sleep.
Yeah. And so, went into that, moved into that place, moved all the equipment from a garage back into that garage. And then it was Strongman Saturdays.
Yeah.
And working here.
Yeah,
and then you started up in hours more, and then I think once I was at like 30, I think, and coaching every morning, some in the after, some evenings, I would be like, okay, no more National.
Right.
Gave them a 2 week notice.
You got to pick. Right?
Yeah, you're picking, and then it was just, I mean, history ever since. And then it was like,
right.
you kept on building more.
Yeah, built back up. So now you've kind of taken us through like. You talked a little bit about how you built your body up. You talked about how you've built your career up. How does somebody else do it? So you're talking, it's, hey, it's so rewarding when somebody comes up to you and says, hey, how do you lift this, or how do you do this?
Yeah.
How do I get leaner? do I get ripped? I want to get lean. What are your three big takeaways for somebody?
Consistency.
Okay.
Consistency is key. Like,
what does that mean?
Like, coming to the gym every day. Like, you know, I always leave out Sundays. I never work out on Sundays. Don't do anything on Sundays. Mm-hmm. But come when you're sore, come to the gym. You can work out something different. I mean, like, come and go hard. Yeah. Like, come and push yourself harder than you think that you can go next time. Right. Mm-hmm. And find someone. It always helps. Which is also a great thing about CrossFit is, like, there's a whole group of people here.
Right.
Someone in that class is going to be better than you.
And they're going to be here tomorrow.
Right. Yeah. Kurt, he's going to be here every day.
Yeah, right? Exactly. So you can always grab him. You know,
and
he'll be here.
And then try and keep up with him.
Yeah.
Right. And then, or try and keep, add a little bit extra weight.
Yeah.
Come in, practice, work on form, you know.
Okay. Consistency, AKA showing up. Number two.
Lift heavy things. I'll still go back to that. Like, there's a reason why.
But conventional wisdom tells us, I have to be devil's advocate here, that you should go long and light.
Mm-hmm.
Explain that to me, why that's not accurate.
So long and light is not going to build muscle mass. Muscle takes...
I don't want to get big and bulky, Jeremy.
That's okay. Your genetics only allow you to get as bulky as your genetics allow you to get,
mm-hmm.
right? So if you're predisposed to being a bodybuilder with just ginormous, huge muscles without steroids, you're going to get that,
mm-hmm.
right? That's just what happens. But you're not going to get that just because you lift weights every once in a while, right? You're going to get leaner. You need more muscle mass,
okay.
right?
What does that do to your metabolism when you have muscle?
Increases the metabolism. Like, mm-hmm. Muscle burns heat, right? Yes. Muscle takes energy to burn and requires energy to be utilized.
Right.
And the energy is from macronutrients in your diet that you put in your face, right?
So we talked about this a little before, but what happens when you do long distance cardio?
Yeah, you catabolize muscle, so you break down muscle, right? So if you take a marathoner,
yes.
right, and you put them next to an Olympic sprinter, like
400
meters, yeah, 100 meters,
yeah.
right, there's going to be a vast notable difference, right? Mm-hmm. 100 meters, maximum effort, anaerobic running, right? If you want to stick with running, do 100-meter sprints, 10 of them, and rest 2 minutes. Sure, you can run.
That's going to be much better for your health
than
doing, you know,
all day.
3-mile run.
Yes. Versus the marathoner. You can't tell me there's very many marathoners that look jacked.
Right.
No. They're usually pretty skinny and lean.
Yeah.
Skinny fat.
Yes.
Yeah. Because all their muscle has been catabolized and they're now utilizing it. They've got a strong heart, they got strong lungs, but they probably aren't strong everywhere else.
So one is be consistent, two is lift heavy things.
Yeah.
What's number three?
You know, I'd have to say find a workout buddy. Find an accountability buddy.
Okay, so we haven't even got the nutrition or being cold yet.
Yeah, haven't even gotten to those three. Like, because if you're not going to do it by yourself, like if you don't have the motivation to do something by yourself, you're not going to do any of it.
Okay, so you start with consistency, coming to the gym.
Maybe even consistency and consistency accountability person, because those two people will be really good together.
Okay,
right. Lift heavy stuff, nutrition.
So, and I think part of the reason, and correct me if I'm wrong, but part of the reason you start with coming to the gym on a frequent basis is the decisions that you're going to make
are
going to be better.
Yeah. And I'm not going to eat a bag of peanut butter M&Ms after I just worked out really hard because what am I going to waste that thing that
you're
just
putting
built
water
out?
In your gas tank versus...
No kidding. Why would I just rebuild myself with peanut butter M&Ms when I could fuel myself with, you know, some good quality proteins.
Okay, so we're eating clean, which means just eat real life food, and we don't need to go into a whole detail on that.
No,
people should
meats, nuts, veggies,
little bit of fruit if it's in season.
Yeah,
or if you're super lean.
Yeah, if you're super lean. Yeah, and you can tolerate carbohydrates like that.
Yeah. What are some hacks? What are some hacks that people can utilize to get lean quick?
I've never been this lean as I am now. As taking cold showers.
So you take cold showers.
Yep.
When?
I take them every night before I go to sleep.
You take them every night before you go to sleep. I take them every morning.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. And I echo that completely. I've worked out now, well, let's say three times.
Three times in a month.
In over a month.
So, yeah, since like December. No, probably since, yeah.
Three times in the last 30-some days.
Yeah.
And I echo what Jeremy just said, is take cold showers.
Oh, my gosh.
You burn fat away. What's another hack for somebody?
Recovery.
Define recovery.
Sleep.
Yes.
You don't get any of your gains if you're not sleeping.
Right.
You could be working out as hard as you can in the gym.
Right.
Eating well and sleeping 4 hours a night. Right. You ain't going to get lean.
Correct.
Ain't going to happen.
Correct.
Because your body needs time to repair itself.
Cool. All right. So to recap for everybody back home or in the car, wherever you are right now, find somebody that you can be accountable to.
Yes.
Okay, a lot of us, most of us, all of us are not good at being accountable to ourselves.
No.
Okay, so one, you're accountable, and that's going to help you show up at the gym often.
Consistency.
And if you can't find somebody, Kurt will be here. So just be accountable to him. Lift heavy things.
Yes, lift heavy stuff.
Yeah, and you're going to see that coming up.
Yes.
So we got open season right now, but when we get out of the open, the focus is going to be, like, we're going to help people get lean.
Yes.
And they're kind of going to help usher him there because it's still conventional wisdom, like, coming from me, like, I still think that long is lean.
Yeah.
But long is skinny and weak.
Yeah.
And not that you're going to, like, turn into some, like, superhuman, but...
No.
You want to have, like, very efficient, dense tissues.
Yes.
So you got to... So your accountability, you're showing up at the gym, you've got you've got heavy things that you're lifting.
Yes.
That is going to help you make good decisions with nutrition.
Yes. Absolutely. Okay?
And then the little hacks... Are taking cold showers, and then eating clean food, sleeping.
Yes.
What about intermittent fasting?
I like it. I think it makes nutrition easier. Due to the fact, so like used to be concerned with, well, I have to eat breakfast. Well, I have to eat now. Okay, no, you don't. It's a way to get your body off of the cycle of going like this all the time.
Yeah.
Right. So that, and we've talked about this past in the gym and everything like that, but like, it allows your body to break down what's already, the energy that's already there.
Yeah.
Right. I like 16-8.
Yep.
Eat at noon. And
from noon to eight.
From noon to eight. Very sustainable. I did that for months.
Yep.
Right. So up until like last week, I was doing that like every day.
Yeah.
And it works fantastic.
So I've done the same thing, or I've done like 2 hour windows in the evening. Now, I move my window back to the morning.
Oh, all right.
So I'm playing with like, 8 to 2.
Yeah.
So I got like a 6 hour window from morning to afternoon. And that's been really interesting.
That's helped your sleep.
Huge. My sleep's ridiculous now.
Yeah.
It's like really, really good. Yeah. So.
And that's because you're going outside of the norm of saying, well, we have to eat at this, and this time. No, you have this, this amount of time that you can eat. If you want to eat in the morning, you eat in the morning. If you want to eat at night, you can eat at night.
Yep.
Like,
so little intermittent fasting, take cold showers.
Yes.
Sleep.
Yes.
Sleep like it's important to you.
Sleep like you're competing for sleep.
Yeah.
Compete your sleep.
More to come on that.
Yes.
Much more to come on that. Find a buddy to work out with, show up often, and lift heavy things.
Correct.
That's Jeremy Whiteford and his journey.
Yes.
Not only getting lean, but to 2020. If they want to find you on Instagram,
j.blackchevy, the opposite of Whiteford. Whiteford, Black Chevy, j.blackchevy.
How many people ask you that?
All the time.
What is Black Chevy? What does this mean?
The opposite of Whiteford.
And you can find me on Instagram, john2020fit. This has been a pleasure. Here's to getting lean, just in time for summer.